Hey there. In this video, we're going to go over how room finder room lists work in Office 365 and then how to create them. So if you create a new event in Office 365, one of the most important features for your users is to be able to find the meeting room locations that they want to reserve. So if we go into locations, they're going to get a pop-up for Room Finder. But by default, there won't be anything here in your Office 365 tenant. It'll be empty. That's because this pulls from a specific type of distribution group in Office 365 called RoomList, and it has to be created in PowerShell. There's no other way to create it. You might think there are distribution groups in Office 365 you can create through the admin portal or end users can create, and that's true. Those are the new unified distribution groups. However, a room list is a classic distribution group, so it has to be created in PowerShell and it has to be given the room list attribute. So conceptually, going over what we're doing is under building in Room Finder, we're going to basically see a list of all of our room lists organized by their building and location attributes. So in a small office, you can just create a single room list. You can call it conference rooms. You don't have to add any attributes to it. If you have multiple offices or multiple floors though, you're going to want to go into Office 365 and configure all the attributes for your room lists. That way they're organized really well under the room finder. I've just created one. I've given it some test attributes that will show up in room finder. I haven't added all of my conference rooms to it, but I will go through the entire process now so that you can see how it works. All right, so here is all of the PowerShell that it takes to create your room lists and set up Room Finder. Our first line here, if you've never worked with PowerShell before on Exchange Online or Office 365, you're going to need to install the PowerShell module for Exchange Online. One other note is that you should set up PowerShell 7 if you haven't already. Windows 10 or 11 might ship with an earlier version of PowerShell. You should go online and update that by downloading the new version of PowerShell. It's an MSI. You install it on your system and updating all that before you install modules or anything. So you'll install the module, and then before you do any Office 365 tasks, you're going to connect to Exchange Online. I've already done that. What it basically does is it pops up a browser window and you just sign in to your Office 365 account. If you're a global admin or a limited admin, use that account. Don't use an end user account because you'll need permissions to do the tasks that we're about to do. Let me add a note. Okay, so as an example, I'm just going to create a new room mailbox so that you see the entire process. That looks correct. If you already have room mailboxes, of course, you don't need to recreate those room mailboxes. As long as they're resource mailboxes, you should be good to go. Now, these will have some default options already set up, like set calendar processing will already be configured for your room mailbox by default when it's created. So it's going to auto accept incoming meetings, and it's not going to allow any booking overlaps. If you've worked with this before, you probably already know what the defaults are. If not, you may need to run a set calendar processing command if you want your mailbox behavior to differ from our default behavior. But that's not anything to do with room lists. So let's get back to Room Finder room lists. So In my simple example here, I don't have a bunch of buildings and floors to break up. I'm just going to add one room list for all my conference rooms. I'm going to call it conference rooms. There we go. Here's our name. You can also use display name. It's going to create a room finder list for my conference rooms, which will be empty. And in about 24 hours, it'll be synced to Outlook with any conference rooms I add. So let's go ahead and add our conference rooms. And a couple of notes on this command right here. I'm using the display name in double quotes. You can also use the email address or UPN of your distribution group or your mailbox if you have that under identity and member. And that command, Add-DistributionGroupMember, added my conference room to my room finder list. Now, in about 24 hours, when I go into the room finder, I'll see another building or location, and my conference room that I just created will appear when I select that one. You repeat the Add Distribution Group Member process for every conference room that you're adding to your list. You create the distribution group step for every building or location in your environment. You don't repeat this for every individual floor in your office. You can change the set place parameter for each of your conference rooms to select different floors inside of your buildings. But you should repeat this for every different building or location you want to show up in the room finder. So, I'll add this note, and I'll add these notes to the description of the video. That should be it. You now know everything you need to know to set up Room Finder in Office 365 and Outlook. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out. Thank you.